Good morning, one and all here. After completing mechanics, the unit 2 we are going to discuss oscillations and waves. So in this topic we are going to discuss the fundamentals of simple harmonic motion, energy of a simple harmonic oscillator, then spring mass system, time period of simple pendulum, compound pendulum and torsion pendulum, which is the example for simple harmonic motion. Then damped oscillations, which is the practical case, then traveling wave motion, then sinusoidal waves on strings, speed of a wave, those things we will discuss, and rate of energy transfer in a wave motion. So the fundamentals of simple harmonic motion means in oscillation, why we have to, in oscillations, why we have to take simple harmonic motion as a fundamental. Because it is the simplest possible oscillation. For example, if you want to study atomic structure, first you will choose hydrogen atom. Why it is so? It is the simplest possible system. One proton, one electron. Remaining things are multiples of that. So to understand oscillation, the fundamental understanding of simple harmonic motion is essential. First of all, what do you mean by periodic motion? Motion of an object that regularly returns to a given position after a fixed time interval. So, motion of an object means the velocity may change, the position may change, the acceleration may change. So, these variables, these parameters, physical parameters, changes with respect to time. That defines motion. But what makes periodic motion? That means the system should repeat itself. The repeating nature constitutes periodic motion. If an object travels from one end to other end, it is not periodic. Suppose if the object travels from one end to other end, A to B, then B to A, and it repeats this process at regular intervals of time, now this same motion becomes periodic motion. See, a motion which is regularly repeated, this regularly repeated is important, in equal periods of time, that means time period is a constant. Keep in mind, time period of a oscillator, periodic motion should be a constant. So, for example, a system changes from one position to other position and come back from that position to initial position. Now, the time taken is 2 seconds. Now, the system changes, moves from initial position to final position and 1 second comes to initial position. Now the time taken is 5 seconds. Now it is not periodic, even though it is repeating. Okay, so equal intervals of time is very, very important. Examples of periodic motion: oscillatory motion, wave motion. These are the two examples. We will see detail about the oscillatory motion in particular. So examples of periodic motion. For example, Earth revolving the Sun at regular interval of time. Earth returning the same position in its orbit around the Sun each year. Then movement of the wall clock. For example, the needle repeat itself regular intervals of time. So these are some examples of periodic motion. As already we pointed out, oscillations and waves is an example of periodic motion. Sound waves, seismic waves. So wave phase, water waves, these are examples of periodic motion. Not only this, even electromagnetic radiation is also a periodic motion. So rotary beam, where the children will play, this is also regular interval, it is repeating. This is an example of periodic motion. Not only this macroscopic system, even if you take a microscopic system, let us take this hydrogen water molecule, HHO. So these molecules will vibrate at regular interval of time. So this is also an example of periodic motion. Now a rocking chair, if you disturb this rocking chair, it will set into oscillation. Okay, this is an example of periodic motion. And a bouncing ball, the ball will repeat itself. We keep in mind, the ball when hits, it slowly it reduces its amplitude, it becomes, finally it becomes rest. So you should always, you should not consider the frictional part. If you include the frictional part, this and this will not be a periodic motion. That means it is not repeating at regular interval of time. For example, if you have friction between this chair and the surface floor, then after some time the oscillation will slow down and becomes zero. So we are considering only when the frictional force is negligible, then simple pendulum, if you disturb the simple pendulum, it tries to make an oscillation and comes to rest because of the air friction. So this is a periodic motion when the frictional force is very, very less. When the friction force is huge, then this is not a periodic motion, and vibration of a musical strings in a guitar. So what I am trying to say, you all systems which is vibrating, you can call periodic motion, provided the frictional contribution is very, very small. When the frictional contribution is huge, then you cannot make a periodic motion for a long time. So if ideally there is no frictional force, it's completely zero, then the system will oscillate forever. The periodic motion continues forever. That means there is no change in amplitude, it will keep on vibrating, never stops. But we know very well, all practical systems, we have the contribution of friction. So the system reduces its amplitude, finally comes to rest. Then spring movement, here in this unit we will spring movement. So if you pull this mass downwards, what happens? The string is stretched and it will try to come back to original state if you release it. So it will make an oscillation due to inertia. Not only that, vibration of bridges. Don't think that bridges are always rigid. You should have minimum oscillation for a good bridge. So the bridge oscillation is also an example of it. Another interesting thing about, don't think that only mechanical system will undergo periodic motion. Here is an electrical circuit, alternating power supply, the alternating current, which is a periodic motion. Okay, so electrical systems also undergo periodic motion. Don't think always mechanical system. For example, mechanical wave, we call them, a special case of mechanical wave, we call them sound waves. Similarly, you have electromagnetic waves, a special case of waves are called visible light, which you can see. So all these are examples of periodic motion. So these are some other examples for periodic motion. So we can have this oscillation. So this oscillation will be a maximum. The amplitude of this is the amplitude. So more the amplitude, you will go further, and here it will be slower. So while moving, you will get slower and slower and stops here and come back, and the velocity is higher here. Once again it becomes slower and slower, it becomes zero here and come back to original position. So the motion is always directed to the center point. Then movement of a swing, for example a tuning fork is disturbed, is hit, it is set into oscillation. So you have different frequencies, 488 hertz, 433 hertz, 512 hertz, 350 hertz, like that. You have different frequencies in the case of tuning fork if you disturb it. These are all examples of periodic motion. Not only that, many examples are there.